Hey, how's it going? Welcome to Rapid Fire Reaper Tutorials, all info, no fluff. Today, I wanted to show you how to recreate the tap to transient function from Pro Tools. So in Pro Tools, the tab is one of those buttons that kind of becomes like a twitch for Pro Tools users because it's a great way of navigating around your track. So basically, I can click on any track and I press tab and it will go to the beginning of the next item available like this. And then if I press tab again, it will go to the end of the item. Then additionally, you can also enable tap to transient. And then that means that my first tab will go to the beginning of the item. And then the next tab cycles through the next transients and items like this. So let's try to recreate this. Now in Reaper, it's a little bit of work to get it to work exactly like that because I can always come and I can add tab to the next transient and items. And tab is one of the special keys. So that means if you want to assign it, you got to first hit this and then go tab. And now it's assigned to tab. And as you can see, mine is already assigned to something else. Let's unassign it. And now if I come here and I hit tab, it'll go to the next tab on my audio. But if I'm here and I press tab, nothing happens. It doesn't go to the start of next item. So that can get pretty annoying pretty fast if you're used to navigating Pro Tools style. So there's a weird fix for that. Let's look at my custom action. And all it does is add an action. And the action is called Zenacius SWS select first items of selected tracks. And then if I string that together with item navigation, move cursor to next transient and items, it all works out. Because though it says select first item of selected tracks, it actually always chooses the next item on selected tracks. So let's once again assign my tab to this special key, tab, okay. So now if I hit tab, it'll go and select the next item. And if I go here and hit tab, it'll go to that item. Also, if I then from here keep tabbing, it'll go to the next transient and items. Now, right now you can see that it's not really going to the next tab, for example, in this here file. So what we can do is bring up our transient detection settings. And I think this is a default hotkey, Command Option Shift and T. So if I bring this up, I can set a threshold for where I want my tab to transient to be. And if we select an item, we'll see this line. So right now my threshold is way too low and I can bring it up. So basically this allows us to specify what qualifies as a transient. So 12 dB. I'm saying is now a transient. And now if I come here, you can see that it works a lot smoother. Now you can dial this in and also you can bring the sensitivity down when you want it to only really select like huge spikes. So this works. And this is something you're not allowed to do in Pro Tools. In Pro Tools, Avid tells you what a transient is, not you. But obviously a transient can be different contextually. So what I have on the bottom track here are sound effects. So those are usually normalized when you get them from a library. So they are pretty loud and you know, a sound effect of an explosion or a door closing is a very kind of quick and heavy transient. And the same thing applies for a kick track. Now you can see in my kick track, for example, my kick is a little bit low. So I can again come and bring this threshold down for it to work the way I want. Or if I come to this rhythm guitar, now rhythm guitars, for example, if you're playing an arpeggio, every time you play a note, that's technically a transient. But because the previous notes are ringing out, sometimes they're not really poking through. So with something like a guitar arpeggio, I can bring up the sensitivity and then bring this down a little. And now you can see these transients, like we can see them in the waveform. They can be detected really quickly. Another thing you have to turn on if you want it to work exactly like Pro Tools is this box, media item selection follows tap to transient. And that basically means if I arrive at the end of the item and I hit tab, it'll go to the next item. Whereas without this, it won't. And now my tap to transient works exactly like Pro Tools does if you have tap to transient selected. If you want the tab to work like tap to transient isn't selected, all you gotta do is assign tab to this key. What would be nice is if there was a way of kind of putting a button on your toolbar, and if you press the button, the tab would be assigned to this custom action, and then if you pressed it again, it would go back to just being assigned to this action. But yeah, so I don't think there's a way for that, but anyway, this is how you do it. So if you're a Pro Tools user, now you can enjoy tab as you known and loved, except with the added bonus of being able to actually tell Reaper what qualifies as a transient. So that's it for today. I hope you enjoyed this video, and if you like the work I do, please donate to me through buymeacoffee.com. The link will be in the description. Thank you so much to Alan Mann for his generous donation. I was truly like speechless when I saw it. It means so much to me. Thank you so much. Yeah, I can't appreciate you enough. And also because I see you on the forum suggesting my videos to people and that just really warms my heart. So thank you so much, Alan. And just let me know what you need and I'll get it to you. All right, take care of yourselves. Bye.